It is indeed a great joy to come into your home, brothers and sisters in the Lord. We truly believe that this year is going to be your year of taking possession, and He has much more for you with His presence. And we truly appreciate your support that keeps this ministry going for you and for others. Today we'll touch on new season and new supply. Now, end of September, we have a series of meetings with Dr. Jim. It was the first seminar that we have after 2.5 years. There was a great turnout. And that week itself at sundown is Rosh Hashanah 2022, the Bible New Year. So a very happy New Year for you. Now we set the theme for this series of meetings with Dr. Jim, Reset and Refire. We don't know. We didn't plan with it because it is Rosh Hashanah, because it's just something that we fit into Dr. James' flight schedule. And nothing happened by accident. I believe that this tells us that this is your new season, new beginning. And get ready for that new things that God is going to do. Great growth, great expansion. Every blessings in every areas of your life, physical, spiritual, relationship. And you know what? The Lord is going to accelerate things as well. And it's almost 1,000 days since the start of the COVID pandemic. It was a challenging time. Many of you lost job, lost your pay, lost your health, lost your time. Some even lost loved one. And the early MCO was especially days of greatest distresses, days of sleeplessness and members into ICU and got to take ventilators. But there's also, we see, 1,000 days of miracle. Many of you shared the amazing testimony what God did despite of all the distresses. And your church also was flooded. But because of friends and because of you, all over, we're able to see it being refurbished in such a beautiful dream center. And God is well able to make up what was robbed, that 1,000 days, because one day to the Lord is 1,000. So He's going to make up for what you can't do for 1,000 days, which is one day of accelerated breakthrough. And for this new season, we can look into Joshua chapter 5. And they add up the produce of the land on the day after the Passover, unleavened bread and parched grain. On that very same day, the manna ceased on the day after they have eaten the produce of the land, and the people no longer had manna, but they ate the food of the land that year. When Joshua was commanded to cross the Jordan, it was the worst of time. The Jordan was at a flood stage. It was the worst of time to cross. And put it this way, God's destiny and blessing, inheritance for you, it's not hinged to the circumstances. It was the worst of time. Joshua experienced unprecedented harvest. And Joshua found when he crossed the Jordan, there was different supply. The manna, the usual manna, ceased, but there were fresh supply. So the same way, it's not an accident that we are entering into new season of supply. The last 1,000 days, almost 2.5 years, in the lockdown, intermittent, we have daily Holy Communion, beginning almost every day, finally to 3 times a week. It has been tough. Many of us are forced to learn new things, and we're going to make do with what we have. Look at this tripod that has been bandaged and even supported with a reversed stool. But now we're entering the new season. the new supply come through the fresh daily manna, which is available through the church app and through Instagram, of course, through the WhatsApp, if you want, from the Zone Pastor. And look at this picture of a typical daily manna. And of course, you have the Kingdom Keys in the School of Vibrant Growth, where we're going to focus on the physical and as well as the hybrid. And Care Group, of course, is the lifeblood of the church, where you're going to set supply, both physical and spiritual. And the daily, or Rhema Holy Communion, will be done once a week. And we're going to beam it on Tuesday. And there's a new way that this Rhema Communion is going to be done. It's going to be short devotion, short ministry time, followed by the Holy Communion. There's not going to be worship song. Why? Because we encourage you, before you watch the Rhema Holy Communion, to worship the Lord yourself or together with your family member. And then each of you take turn to pray, short prayer, before you on the YouTube. And you can do it perhaps after meals, perhaps on Friday, Saturday, or any days. So worship, then listen to the word and receive whatever ministry. And of course, get ready for your communion. And you know what? At sundown, shofar, we're going to be blown all over the Holy Land, proclaiming Rosh Hashanah, the new beginning. You know what? The ram is going to let you blow his horn alive. It's going to be slaughtered first. So it's the same way, Hamrim must know, we're able to have Rosh Hashanah because the Son of God, 2,000 years ago, gave his life for us. The Lord Jesus Christ said, "Take and eat, this is my body broken for you." This cup is a new covenant in my blood, pour out for you for the forgiveness of all your sin. Ora bara shalom bara hirian dala baraka. Hirian dala baraka. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because the blood has been applied. We thank you, Lord Jesus, there's going to be that release of the anointing of favor. But all the household, brothers and sisters that are watching this event right now, thank you, Lord, for the amazing, amazing, amazing taking of possession, even in this time, they're going to be accelerated into the verse of time as Joshua entered the Jordan. Into the verse of time, with all the challenging situation around about us, Father, we know that truly your inheritance is going to be released because the Holy Spirit is in us, restraining the power of all those negative forces. Kidney condition being healed in Jesus' name. We command that growth in that liver be gone in the mighty name of Jesus. Neck condition be healed in Jesus' name. Shoulder pain be gone in Jesus' name. Migraine be gone in Jesus' name. Lung condition be made whole. In Jesus' name. Here, eye condition, be made whole in Jesus' name. Just lay hand on the parts of the body that is infirm even right now. Receive that healing. By the stripe of Jesus, we are healed in Jesus' name. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord smile on you and release you his favor. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.